Okay, this is the first video tutorial of Lab 6, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to do a whole bunch of calculations much more quickly, virtually simultaneously, using an Excel spreadsheet. Well, I'm going to use Excel because I'm a PC user, and you can use whatever spreadsheet software your particular computer supports. They all work essentially the same. Now, this can be really helpful because here in the middle of Lab 6, we have this long table. There are 30 entries in this table. And for each entry, we have to do essentially the same calculation. And it would get rather boring and tiresome to do the same calculation over and over and over again using a calculator, punching the numbers in. But we can speed this up using a spreadsheet. Can also prove useful at the end of this lab, where there are a few other tables that are a little bit shorter, but you could do the calculations in a spreadsheet in much the same way, and I'll show you a little bit of that. And the skill will also be useful in some of the remaining labs where we'll use a spreadsheet to speed things along, but also just in general. There are lots and lots of applications for spreadsheets out there in the real world, and so having some very basic spreadsheet skills, it's a good thing to have under your belt. So I'm going to show you just the absolute basics here. Okay, let me share my screen. Okay, here we are looking at Lab 6, and we're down in the procedure, Part A. If we scroll down here, here's that long table I was mentioning, 30 entries. And each entry is a different globular cluster orbiting our galaxy. There are about 150 of these star clusters that orbit our galaxy. This is a random sampling of about 30 of them. So the first column just numbers them 1 to 30. The next two columns give the positions of the globular clusters in galactic longitude and galactic latitude coordinates. And this is something that will be important in the next video tutorial. So we'll come back to these two columns there. But for this tutorial, we're really focused on these last three columns. Average apparent magnitude, which is like brightness, average absolute magnitude, which is like luminosity, and distance. Now, this is not of the globular cluster, but of an RR Lyrae star, a variable star in the globular cluster. If you think back to the last lab, you chose a globular cluster, you chose an RR Lyrae star in that globular cluster, and you observed it, you know, over and over again over the course of many days, and learned how to process that data, how to analyze it, to turn it into a light curve and a folded light curve, and to measure the average apparent magnitude, the average brightness of that variable star. And these stars are special because they all have essentially the same luminosity or average absolute magnitude. And I'm not going to tell you what that is. It's a constant value, the same for all of them. And go back to Lab 5 in the background section if you need a reminder as to what that is. But that goes in this column here. So we've given you the brightnesses, so you don't have to do that whole analysis over like you did in Lab 5. You learned how to do it once. Now here's the result of 30 of them, and we're going to use that information to go to the next level. And in this, so this is the average brightness. In this column, you're going to put the average luminosity again as an average absolute magnitude. And then we're going to use those two things to calculate the distance, which is something that we also did in Lab 5. But again, we don't want to do it over and over and over again. So let's get this into a spreadsheet. I'm going to copy everything in this table. Control C to copy. Now I'm going to go to a spreadsheet here. And I have a blank tab open. Control V, I'm going to paste it. So everything's moved over. And we can see we go down to 30 here. Now, one thing, when you copy from a web page into a spreadsheet, if you have any interactive buttons, boxes, things like that, they copy over. And they're really just a nuisance in the spreadsheet. You can see these are the entry boxes from the web page, but we can't really use them. And they're hard to get rid of. It's hard, you can't just copy them and hit the delete button. They don't disappear that easily. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right-click and insert, right-click and insert. And then maybe I'll grab these headers. I'll copy them and Control X, Control V to move them over. So I've just taken these logic boxes and moved them out of the way over to the side. Okay. So again, in this column here, we have the average apparent magnitude, think brightness. Here we have the average absolute magnitude, think luminosity, and that's something you will enter. And here is the distance to that star and hence to that globular cluster, and we calculate that from the brightness and the luminosity. There's an equation for that. We learned it in Lab 5. Again, you can go back and review it in the background sections of that lab. But let's just enter it in. Now, in a spreadsheet, you want to use the equal sign. That's what tells it that you're doing a calculation. Instead of just entering a number, we're entering an equation, and it will calculate for us. And the equation for distance, given little m, the apparent magnitude, and big M, the absolute magnitude, is 0.01 kiloparsecs, but we don't type in the unit. We just keep the number here, the units listed there. 0.01 kiloparsecs times 1.585 raised to the power of, and so for that we use the caret symbol. You can see it here. You can also see it up there. So 0.01 times 1.585 to the parenthesis. Don't forget the parenthesis. If you forget the parentheses, you'll get the wrong calculation. And it's the apparent magnitude minus the absolute magnitude. So I just clicked on this cell for the apparent magnitude, typed in a minus sign, clicked on that cell for the absolute magnitude, and close the parenthesis. Now the whole equation is there. I hit enter. And it's calculating it based upon the entries. Now, right now, it doesn't have an entry for the absolute magnitude, think luminosity. You still have to put that in there. It's assuming zero at the moment. And again, I'm not going to tell you what that is. You should be able to remember it from the previous lab, or you can go look it up. But I'll just demonstrate. I can type in, okay, I just typed in 1, and it does a new calculation. I can type in 2, new calculation. Minus 1, new calculation. So I'm just going to delete that there. You'll enter the correct value, and then I'll do the calculation. Now, that's the first column. What we want is to get this in every column. And so we've entered the equation here. So click on that box, and then come down and find the corner. Grab it and pull it down. And it propagates the logic. Like in this one here, it used D2 and E2. That's this and this. But in the next one, it was smart enough to realize I wanted D3 and E3. And the next one, D4 and E4. So it propagates the logic. So to finish this out, you just have to type in the average absolute magnitude of all our Lyrae stars, enter it there, and then grab its corner and drag it down. And that way you don't have to type that same number in 30 times. It will copy it over 30 times and drag it all the way to the bottom, and the distances will update, and then you have your distances. And you'll want to enter those back into WebAssign for grading and the absolute magnitudes as well. But keep the spreadsheet because we'll use it in the next video tutorial as well. But before I let you go, I just want to mention that down at the bottom of the lab, we're going to do a similar exercise, not with our Lyraes, but Cepheids. And again, we learned how to use them in the previous lab, in Lab 5 as well. And I've copied over the spreadsheets here. And again, we have these entry boxes that are a real pain. I'm going to just make that column bigger, get the entry box out of the way. And here we have the apparent magnitude of a Cepheid in a nearby galaxy. These are the nearby galaxies. This is the magnitude of the Cepheid. This is its period. Over here, we have the absolute magnitude. And remember, with Cepheids, they don't all have the same absolute magnitude. It depends on the period. There's an equation for that. And then the distance. Again, we have these entry boxes, so I'm going to right-click insert, right-click insert. I'm going to copy these headers, Control X, Control V. But then you go through the same process. You enter the equation for the absolute magnitude given the period, which is given in this cell here. And here you enter the equation for the distance given the apparent magnitude and the absolute magnitude, which are given in this cell and this cell. And once both of those equations are entered, you can highlight and drag down, highlight and drag down, and it will do the calculations for you. And then in the final table here, we have the angular diameter that you're going to measure in arc minutes, and we need to calculate it in degrees, and then calculate the diameter. And these all have entry boxes, so I'm going to insert, Control X, Control V, again, just to get these out of the way. And you're going to measure, you can't do it for all of these, they're not all visible all year long. Probably you'll have maybe three at any given time of year. And you're going to enter the angular diameters that you measure in arc minutes there. You're going to calculate it in degrees. And that is, you know, basically just equal to the number of arc minutes divided by 60. So we have some logic there. And then the diameter. And there's an equation for that. That's in the lab as well. And you'll enter that equation there. It's basically, I'll spell it out here. It is the angular diameter in degrees divided by 360 times 2 times pi. You just enter the word pi and click that. Times the distance away, which is over here. And right now it came up zero because we don't have anything in there. But again, you can highlight these two boxes, drag the logic down, and the calculations will be done for you. Okay, that's it. Again, you can do all those calculations by hand on a calculator if you're more comfortable that way. But this will speed things up for you.